Nk'uko mumaze iminsi mudusaba amasomo y'abana mwakifashisha mu rugo, turayabohereje kuri videwo kandi nta kiguzi tubasaba. Mukomeze kwiga neza mukurikiza gahunda yo kwirinda COVID-19.
Good morning once again, my learners. I encourage you to follow this lesson of today. As you see on the blackboard, we are going to run a lesson of English. Following what you have seen about this active and passive voice, you remember that last time we studied how can we change active voice into passive voice, respecting the main tenses, where we have seen present tense, where we have seen past tense. Today we are going to see how can we change active voice into passive voice when sentences are in the future. I would like to remind you that the future tense, it is a part of tense that tell us the action that will happen. So dear learners, you are going to observe the sentences I'm going to write below. Then you will see how the tense of future is formed. On the blackboard, you have 5 examples, and I would like to invite you to follow this and observe these sentences I've written on the blackboard. You see that the first one is, John will eat cassava. That is the first sentence, John will eat cassava. The second one is, they will help the old people. The third one is, we shall support government projects. The fourth is, Keza will be writing on the blackboard. Last sentence we have, I shall be driving a car. Those sentences which are on the blackboard, all of them, they are in active voice. That you have on the blackboard are in active voice, but in a tense called future. If you remember, I have shown you the way of forming future tense, where we have subject plus shall or will plus verb. This is the formula of future tense. We have a subject plus shall or will plus verb. This is future simple tense. That is the point number one or part one, which is in the future. Then we are going to see the formula number two, which tells us future continuous tense, where we have subject plus shall or will plus be plus verb plus ing. Info. That is the formula of future continuous tense. So by observing these sentences we have on the blackboard, they are grouped into two parts of future tense. If I say John will eat cassava, there, this is future simple tense. The following is they will help the old people. The third one is we shall support government project. And the fourth is Keza will be writing. This one is future continuous tense because there is verb to be. And plus verb write plus ing form. And I shall be driving a car. Dear learners, by observing these sentences, which are in active voice, now we are going to see how can we change them into passive voice. How can we change these sentences we have into passive voice? The skills that you have to know about this is, when we are changing any sentence which is in future tense or future continuous tense into passive voice, first of all, we put the verb to be in future, then plus past participle of verb given. I repeat, when we are changing a sentence which is in future tense, can be, for example, simple future tense or can be future continuous tense. You have to do what? You have to put verb to be into the tense of future where the sentence is, and then after we add past participle of verb given. So you are going to write that rule to be followed when we are changing a sentence which is in future tense into passive voice. Yeah, as I've said this, when we are changing these sentences that you have written there into passive voice, first of all, we have to change verb to be into the tense. The sentence is, and then plus past participle verb given. When we are changing any sentence which is in the future tense, into passive voice, we put the verb to be in the tense of the sentence, then we add the past participle of verb giving. Let's come back for the first sentence we have. Our sentences, the first one is, John will eat cassava. That sentence is in the future simple tense. Now, for ourselves, we are going to change this sentence into passive voice. Now, what we see that our sentence is in the future tense. Now, as usual, we are going to change this sentence is in a passive voice. I start with cassava. That is an object. Then after writing cassava as an object, we put the verb to be into future simple tense. So I say cassava will be, this is future simple tense of verb to be, then plus past participle of verb given. The past participle of verb we have, the verb we have is verb to eat. So the past participle of it is eaten. So I say cassava will be eaten by John. I repeat again. Our sentence we have is John will eat cassava. So, dear learners, you have to know that we have said that for changing this sentence into passive voice, first of all, we have to conjugate the verb to be in future tense according to the sentence we have. So I say that I shall be. I shall be, you will be, he will be, she will be, it will be, we shall be, you will be, then they will be. That is the way of conjugate verb to be into future simple tense. Now, here we are going to learn about future continuous tense. How can I say? I say that I shall be being. You will be B. So, dear learners, when we are after conjugating verb to be into future simple tense or future continuous tense, what we do, we take our sentence and we put into the tense of verb to be is. For example, the first question we have, John will eat cassava. Our sentence by default from this, we see that it is in future simple tense. Then we come back for changing into passive voice. We say that cassava, this cassava of course can be replaced by it. So I say that it will be, the reason why I have written here, cassava will be eaten by John. That is how can we do the first sentence. We put the verb to be into the tense of given a sentence in active voice. Then after, conjugate the verb to be into the tense of the sentence is, we add the past participle of verb to eat is eaten. Then we write word by, then we end by a subject. Coming back for number two. This was number one. Number two. Our sentence is, they will help the old people. They will help the old people. So, we are going to change that one into passive voice. We say that the old people will be helped by them. The second sentence also is in future simple tense. Now for changing it, we begin with the object, saying that the old people will be helped by them. That is how can we change active voice into passive voice when the sentence is in future tense. We are going on example number 3. Example number 3 is Keza will be writing on the blackboard. Keza will be writing on the blackboard. Before from the formula we have seen about future continuous tense, you have seen that this will be writing. The form of this sentence is in the future continuous tense. As we have done for the first one, we have also to conjugate verb to be into future continuous tense, then you add past participle of verb given. I repeat again. When we are changing active voice into passive voice, when a sentence is in a future continuous tense, what we can do, we conjugate verb to be into future continuous tense, and then after add past participle of verb given. The verb here we have is verb to write. So we are going to example number 3, changing this one into passive voice. Say on the blackboard, on the blackboard, this can be replaced by it. On the blackboard will be. That is the future continuous tense of verb to be. Will be. Then I add the past participle of verb we have, verb to write. Will be being written. By Keza. For this example number 3, have you seen that for doing it well, first of all, we conjugate the verb to be into the tense of a given sentence. Our sentence is, Keza will be writing on the blackboard. This is a future continuous tense. And for changing it into passive voice, first of all, we conjugate the verb to be into future continuous tense. Then we add the past participle of verb given. The reason why we have that on the blackboard will be being written by Keza. I think have you understood? Coming back for our example number 4. It says that I shall be driving a car. This also it is in the future continuous tense. So I say that a car, conjugate verb to be into future continuous tense. You know that a car can be replaced by it. A car will be being driven by me. So, dear learners, what I encourage you to do, what to do to convert or to change those sentences into passive voice, first of all, you have to know the tense of verb to be, then after, add past participle of verb given. Therefore, from these examples you have on the blackboard, and for what we have seen in the tip, we are going to focus on the ways of changing passive voice into active voice. That is the next point that we are going to run. I think for changing active voice into passive voice, have you understood well and the way of doing that? So now we are going to see How can we change passive voice into active voice? I'd like to inform you that when we are changing passive voice into active voice, we have to focus on the tense of verb to be. Then after, we put the whole sentence in the tense of verb to be. So follow as usual well, and observe the sentences I'm going to write. On the blackboard, we have five sentences which are in a passive voice. All of us are going to read together them, and then after we discover ourselves the tense those sentences are. One is, houses are built by us. Houses are built by us. Second, Janity is being baptized by priests. Number three is, a dog was killed by a lion. Number four, a bridge has been being constructed by them. Last sentence is, mountain gorillas will be visited by tourists. Dear learners, when we observe these sentences we have you seen that there is the tense of verb to be is different according to the sentences that we have. For the first one, we have that houses are. Our verb to be is in simple present. For the first sentence, we have seen that our sentence is in simple present. Second one is, Janet is being, that is present continuous tense of verb to be. Is being, that is present continuous tense of verb to be. Then for the third sentence, we have was, that is verb to be in simple past. Then number four, we have has been. That is present perfect tense of verb to be. And the last one we have, that will be. That is future simple tense of verb to be. So learners, I have told you that when we are changing passive voice into active voice, what we have to know? One, we have to know the tense of verb to be in given sentences. Then after, we have to know also past participle of verb given. If you observe here we have verb to build, that is build. Here we have verb to kill, Then we have verb to construct, and the last we have verb to visit. All of them, they are their past participle. We have them here. Now, how can we change these sentences we have in active voice? One, you have to know that changing those sentences into active voice, I may put the whole sentence in the tense of verb to be is. If verb to be is in the present, the whole sentence should be in the simple present. If the sentence is in the simple past, the whole sentence should be in the simple past. If verb to be is in the future, the whole sentence should be in the future. So, let's give you a short time for break. Then after we come back for changing those sentences in a active voice, so get time for the last.
Ya ishuri rimwe rikere ritunganye rikomoka ku ntumwa umwana wakwiye kwigamo.
Beautiful.
Uretse uryumve mubyeyi muri uku kwambera ujyana abana bagiye kwiga.
Mubye yutifuriza umwana we jo hazaza heza cyane cyane iyo ubonye umwana wawe yiga neza mu ishuri ryiza kandi abasha kuvuga indimi z'amahanga neza adategwa akarusho kandi bitaguhenze inzira nimwe ni ishuri ryitwa Orion School ryaje ari igisubizo ku ireme ry'uburezi. Orion School ni ikigo cy'amashuri gifite icyiciro cy'incuke gardienne na primaire kizwiho umwihariko wo kugira abarimu b'inzobere mu burezi no kwigisha mu buryo budasanzwe. Abana bahiga usanga bavuga igifaransa, icyongereza, igiswahili kandi bakabivuga badategwa mu gihe gito. Twigisha na program ya Cambridge. Orion School ni ikigo giherereye mu karere ka Gasabo, umurenge wa Gisozi hafi yo mu Gakinjiro. Babyeyi mu gihe turi kugana mu ntangiriro z'amashuri, banguka wandikisha umwana wawe. Ejo hazaza azagushimire ko wamuhitiyemo neza, agakura n'ubumenyi asaruye muri Orion School. Waduhamagara kuri 0788 367 98. Tambuka utegure neza ejo hazazaho umwana wawe umuzana kwiga muri Orion School, kuko uburezi bwiza ni wo murage mwiza w'iki gihe. Orion School, Nikaribu.
Okay.
Let's send those sentences I have given you in passive voice. For the first sentences, you see that houses are built by us. This us is acting as an object. If you remember, I told you that when a subject became an object, there are some changes happen. So us is the first person plural, where it becomes we, where it acts as a subject. So we say that we, verb to be is in simple present tense, means that our verb to build should be in a simple present tense. So we say that we build houses. The first sentence is we build a house. This build is in a simple present tense because our verb to be we have here in passive voice is in a simple present tense. So we put the whole sentence in a simple present tense. The example number two is Janet is being baptized by priest. There, verb to be is in a present continuous tense. Means that we are going to put the whole sentence in a present continuous tense. I begin with priest. So I say that a priest is baptizing. Baptizing Janet. That is how can we do? A priest is baptizing Janet because our verb to be we have here in passive voice is in present continuous tense. So I put my sentence in a present continuous tense. Coming back for example number 3. A dog was killed by a lion. If you remember, when you conjugate verb to be and find was or were, immediately it tells you that that verb to be is in a simple past. So we put the whole sentence we have in a simple past, respecting the verb given, there we have verb to kill. So I said that a lion killed a dog. A lion killed a dog. Our sentence, our verb, we have a verb to kill, which should be in a simple past because verb to be we have here is in a simple past. Coming back for example number 4, a bridge has been being constructed by them. There, we focus on verb to be. Our verb to be has been being. If you remember that here it is present perfect continuous tense. Now, our verb we have is verb to construct. We should put this whole sentence in present perfect continuous tense by saying that bridge has been being constructed by them. So, number 4, I say that they have been constructing. Constructing a bridge. You see that our sentence is in the present perfect continuous tense because the verb to be here we have is in the present perfect continuous tense. The reason why we put the whole sentence into present perfect continuous tense. So, example number 5, we have mountain gorillas will be visited by tourists. You see that our verb to be here is in a future simple tense. So we put the whole sentence in a future simple tense by starting with tourists. Will visit. Will visit mountain gorillas. So, by if from this sentence, we have these 5 sentences, you see that both are in a active voice, by if from this passive voice we have. I think that I've understood well. By starting where I have been starting, present tense, past tense and future tense. So now, apart from that, dear learners, as usual, you are going to do the exercises related about changing passive voice into active voice or changing active voice into passive voice. I think that will be simple to you because have you understood well the ways we use to change the sentences respecting the tense of any verb given. So follow well and do the exercises. talk about you have 8 sentences that you are going to do as exercises by referring to the tense of each sentence, and then for yourselves, you will change it into passive voice where necessary or active voice according to the sentence you have. For the first one, we have that Peter has finished the heavy work. Dear learners, as usual, you observe these sentences and you find out the tense of it. The second one is classrooms are being cleaned by students. Number three, we took a lot of mangoes. Number four is this house was repaired by a mason. Number five, she will help her cousin. Exercise number six, I am teaching English lesson. Exercise number seven is John had beaten James. The last one is learners will be revising their lessons. So, dear learners, I encourage you to do this work as you do for others and follow well. First of all, revise what you have studied by starting where we began until now. Then answer those exercises in the notebook. After answering them, you photocopy them, then you submit as it is, not later 5 p.m. and the results will be seen by you after some time. Thank you very much for attending, and thank you very much for active participation. Stay home. As it is, even as we are at home, but make sure that you have to follow and to accomplish all government policies based on COVID-19. For any problem or suggestion, you may refer from the contact number below for this lesson. Thank you very much. We love you. God bless you.